All right, let me welcome you guys. Today I'm gonna take this beautiful Husqvarna Vitpilen 401 for a spin, and well, I hope you enjoy it. My GoPro camera strapped. I'm gonna change the different modes. This bike's got two modes, so you can have all road or Supermoto. Idea is to take the side lane and basically turn around to go the other way, so I'm gonna take another route to the place where I'm going to. So well, see you in a while. So, this bike, I must say, is quite comfy. Except for me, I'm not that young anymore. My shoulder girdle and my hands in this cafe racer style, where you have to put quite a bit of weight on the handlebars, so my hands get tired after a bit of riding. So, in fact, best to try and stop every, let's say, 100Ks, 150Ks, because otherwise, my hands start becoming numb. So, in fact, if you have the same problem, I think Vitpilen will be the better ride for you. It's got a slightly different position, so I think that's all about the position of riding. When it comes to show you guys a bit of faster riding, it goes to 100, close to 150Ks without any problems. So I took this motorway here and trying to see what's going on. So what's the definite advantage of this bike? Well, I can tell you, it's really light. So it's 150Ks without fluids, basically. There's a almost 10-liter gas tank. And well, as for a bike which is almost 400cc, you have just enough power to overtake anything you want or you imagine to. There are some add-ons, so accessories you can get to make the bike not only look better but also to travel easier, with some accessories for small accessories for luggage. And well, I enjoy the ride immensely when it comes to the accelerations, to the speed. I think it's pretty fun. And I can tell you that obviously this is based on KTM engine, so it's one cylinder and it behaves slightly different than, let's say, Duke or KTM that you've ridden, but it's pretty fun still, having in mind the lightness of the bike. What I do like during this ride is definitely the fact that the clocks show you the range, expected range from the fuel you have in your tank. So that's a definite plus. What I didn't like, and sometimes it's got really irritating, is the fact that obviously the red light tells you or indicates that you need to shift gear. But then when you ride on the sixth gear, it keeps on shining, because when you reach the top revs, it still stays there. So I think Husqvarna should do something about it, so this is irritating. It pops up and lights up every time you accelerate slightly more on the sixth gear, so this is a definite downgrade to the thing. Obviously it's a detail, but it's, you know, something keeps flashing in your face, red, so this is it becomes irritating after a while. when it comes to accelerations and speed, yes, there is a difference when it comes to the Supermoto. You will tell the difference, obviously. And also when it comes to, let's say, overtaking or squeezing yourself in traffic, it's really easy. This bike, it looks pretty small. So if you're a huge guy, let's say 150 kg and almost 2 meters, you may look funny on the bike. So the average size and weight person will look okay, but if you're a huge, you may look like on a pit bike. So in fact, this is important when it comes to the looks of the rider.